Hello everybody and welcome to another guide video, this time on a game that I haven't spotlighted on my channel yet, but I've been playing pretty excessively the last year or so. Payday 2, and this is a guide for, well, at least advanced Payday players, because I have a skill build for you that I've been trying out the past couple of months, and I think it's got something quite unique going for it. Let me show you. The problem with Payday is that if you don't have a crew of two or three people to accompany you in a crew on hand, and you still want to play, you just want to drop in and see what awaits you, but in order to do that you are at the mercy of CrimeNet, which you can see right here with all these people playing, offering games, and you have generally no idea what's happening. Of course there's this little ghost icon in the corner there that shows you that the crew hasn't been detected yet, but on the other hand, you have no idea if the heist is supposed to go loud in a second or whatever. So it's best to be prepared, right? There's like all sorts of missions that either could go loud, like Big Oil or any kind of bank heist, of course, or Go Bank or Uranium Job or whatever you can think of. Most Payday missions will allow for the job to go loud. So, or also some missions will have multiple days, and those can be either stealthed or played loud, just guns blazing. So my idea was to have a skill build that accounts for all of this, that gives you the ability to go into any kind of game and still lets you be helpful for the whole team. And let's jump right in, huh? So here are all my skills, starting with Mastermind. Got some med skills, cable ties, control freak, dominator for hostages. We got transporter, of course, underdog, tough guy, and enforcer, as well as stun resistance. Got some drill skills in here and a basic sentry gun, as well as additional body bag, sprinter, fast hands, ECM specialist for two upgraded ECMs that make it possible for you to override pagers, 9 lives, aced, which we'll get to in a second. In fugitive we have hidden blades, so we can kill silently, 6 skin, 6 sense, run and gun, Winston Wolf for another body bag, and Swan Song upgraded. And this works together with a crook perk deck, which allows you to get a dodge chance for wearing the lightweight ballistic vest. This is very important. So you'll get a 25 dodge value here, which will help a lot in combat. Of course, you'll want to not wear this in stealth if you can, because it gives you well, let's see here. This is my usual stealth loadout. So if you're wearing the vest, it gives you 6 additional detection risk. So bear that in mind. And yeah, how do we do this? Well, any good player will tell you that all these skills that I've selected right here, it paints a pretty shitty picture, but my perk deck is called Compromise for a reason. That means that you'll be skilled in many different categories here, but you'll not get the top tier skills like Inspire, Pistol Messiah, Iron Man, Overkill, Bulletproof, Camera Loop, Lockpicking, Expert, Akimbo, Sneaky Bastard, Low Blow. These are all skills that I need to compromise. I mean, I can't get them because I'm getting other stuff in the lower tiers. So right off the bat, that's a black mark against this build. I am aware of that, and that's why I'm only recommending this build to advanced players who know their way around Payday and who don't want to play Deathwish with this build. But let's be honest, if you want to play Deathwish missions for real, either you know what you're in for, so you go in with a high dodge mastermind fugitive or something like that, or like a high enforcer tech build, whatever, stuff like that. And you don't need to, you don't have this level of not being prepared account for. So yeah, this is definitely too weak for Deathwish, but if you're playing Deathwish, you probably won't be in the situation that this skill set tries to provide for you. So, how does this go with stealth? Like I said, this is the compromise build is supposed to make you more flexible. So I have the Control Freak perk in here, so you can use Control Freak like in Go Bank to subdue hostages so they don't call. You have Cable Guy to give your team supply of cable ties to get more hostages. You got, of course, ECM with pager delays. So if you wanna join a game and suddenly somebody says, "Well, we're doing an ECM rush," you'll be prepared for that. Or the body bags, of course, also help. One body bag from Cleaner and another one from Winston Wolf. So that's good. Also, you know, packing bags and throwing them around better is another basic perk that you wanna have in any kind of stealth game. But of course, you're missing stuff like extra lockpicking, of course, like I said, or Dead Presidents, but I'd say Dead Presidents is really not worth it, at least in higher levels. And even if you want the extra loot with loose items, the extra spending cash, there's usually at least one person on the team that has this perk. But in my opinion, you don't really need it. Also, well, of course, you can mark guards with Chameleon, but that's you know, that's a skill that's also just very basic. I've aced Sixth Sense as well, because sometimes you need to get into a door which we usually have to open with ECM overdrive, but we don't have that, so at least with Sixth Sense you can pick up items in casing mode, so you're just snatching a key card so you can open certain doors. Voila. So that's good for stealth. I don't think I've forgot anything. When it goes loud, of course, you get the medic perks, painkillers and combat medic. So if you revive people, they don't go down immediately again. Just right after you revive them. But you'll have to go in close, and you won't have Inspire to help you out. So you gotta be in the moment. But the rest of my skills compensate or help out with that by going right into the action. First of all, you'll go down, of course, sometimes because of this playstyle. That's what 9 lives are for. You'll be able to go into bleed out 4 times instead of 3, and you'll have a chance of getting up from bleed out without somebody reviving you of 35%. So that's very, very good, because you'll be kind of the person on the team that just pulls the cart out of the mud, basically. So you want stuff like this, as well as Swan Song, because if you go down right before you do, you'll have 9 seconds of invincibility, first of all, in which you can either like maybe revive somebody on the team, maybe somebody who has Swan Song, or somebody who has Inspire, for example, if he's a very important target, or at least while you go down and do some other stuff, you'll be able to just spend these 9 seconds just eliminating everything, like in a whole room or in the general vicinity, because you don't have to reload your guns while doing it. So it's basically like the Bulletstorm perk. So that this is kind of a boost to your 9 lives. So these work in nice synergy to each other. What else do we have? Of course, because you will want to be in the action most of the time, when you're going loud with the compromise, you want Underdog, so that you have a damage bonus and damage resistance while enemies are around you. It also helps that your bleed out health is increased by 25%, so you'll have even more time while you're laying on the ground bleeding to death to do some more damage extra. And of course, also stun resistance, it's nice to have, you know. Not having to deal with so much bullshit from flashbangs, which are still very, 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 very unfair in this game. What else did I forget here? Of course, with Dominator, you'll be able to take a hostage. That's very, very important skill to have, even if you don't go and ace that skill or go even higher with Joker. Because you might just be the last person on a team and everybody is in custody, so you'll have to be able to at least take a hostage. And that's the bare minimum, but I think you can manage. And other stuff like stamina and, of course, transporter helps as well. Now for equipment. That's another bad mark against the compromise build, because all the equipment you have, except for ECMs, is very basic. So you'll only have one doctor bag, you'll only have one ammo bag, you'll only have one, two trip mines, the basic level of trip mines, I don't use them very much, or one basic sentry gun. But sometimes you'll want to have the sentry gun at least as an option because of maybe some achievement, or I don't know. you'll figure something out. Of course, ECM specialist is pretty important if you want to do stealth missions. And there's also the minimum amount of first aid kits. So you're very weak in terms of equipment, but also very flexible. So if your team is lacking something, some particular thing like ammo bags or whatever, you will be able to provide for that. And you get anything except for the body bag case, unfortunately. Also, you might have seen that there are still 8 skill points left to assign. That is by design, because we don't have any weapon specialization yet with our skills. So you can take this blueprint as a template, and then you can, well, customize it to your liking if you like. For example, if you like pistols, you can get Equilibrium Aced for 4 points, and where's the other one? You can get Trigger Happy Basic, for example. That helps you out if you want to go with pistols, or if you want to go with shotguns, you can go Shotgun Impact and Ace it, and pick Shotgun CQB as the roundup skill. Or if you want to go with rifles, you can Ace Rifleman and Sharpshooter. Or if you want SMG, you also have SMG Specialist. Or you can mix and match if you want to use any combination of these guns. You can mix and match, basically. So there's something for everybody in here. Hopefully you can see what I was going for with this skill build. Like I said, it's supposed to be, you're the player who comes in and saves the day, because you can pretty much do everything. You're a jack of all trades, but master of none. So in order to show you what this skill build can do, why don't we just have a second here and see what's in Sky and Crimenet, and pick out any kind of map that requires stealth and or shooting. So there we go.
Split into two. contracted to ship the voting machines to their final destination. With a little tactical wizardry, we're going to make those machines a bit more sympathetic to the elephant's mayoral candidate. That slimy ball bag, McKendrick. Get in there, get them hacked, get out. Simple. Once again, the elephant is extending his stealth bonus if you can keep it quiet.
Thank you.
Alright, so this was a nice little demonstration of what this compromise build can do. I would like for you to well, just post your comments, see maybe if you wanna try it out yourself, tell me what your experiences were with the skill build, and give me some criticism if you don't agree with some of my choices. Maybe you can compromise some more and get some other, powerful skill that I've forgotten or that I couldn't get with my current setup, and by compromising somewhere else. I would like to hear that, or maybe you want to share one of your own, maybe more unconventional skill sets that you've come up with. So yeah, thank you very much for watching. This was a well, we'll see. Maybe I'll do some more Payday content. I don't really know. There's no plans for it yet. Maybe you want to check out my other stuff. I'm doing, well, all sorts of let's plays on my channel. RPGs, puzzle games, shooters, pretty much everything you can imagine. So do check that out, and I don't know, consider subscribing if you like my stuff, and show me your support in any way you can. So once again, thank you very much for watching. Have fun with my build, spread it around, and I'll see you guys later.